Hey everyone, there are a ton of free VPNs out there, but many of them are either malware in disguise or they just simply don't work very well. So today I will be sharing with you my top two favorite free VPNs or virtual private network services that you can use without paying a single cent. If you like content like this, please do consider subscribing for more free tech videos, but I know your time is valuable, so let's go ahead and dive right into these picks. Now, having tested several free VPN options out there across different platforms and countries, the first service that I found that is both genuinely free and well trusted in the industry is ProtonVPN. You might have heard Proton's products through their secure private email service, ProtonMail, which I also love, by the way. And while ProtonVPN does offer paid service plans that you may have seen online, the free version is surprisingly generous and unique, and you can sign up for free right now through the link in the description and pinned comment below. But from my perspective, here's why ProtonVPN's free VPN service is a fantastic value. Of course, I guess it's free, but the absolute key value proposition is that the free version of ProtonVPN does not limit your usage of data while using the VPN service. Now, this may seem like a complete no-brainer, but many, if not most, of the free VPNs on the market today cap your data usage in some way. That might be 500 megabytes or a gigabyte per day. Maybe it's monthly on a monthly basis. And you will find limits on what you can do with a VPN like that, because modern web browsing can be very data intensive. With all the video and image content out there, everything you do is very bandwidth intensive. And so you might find that it's limited when you don't have unlimited data. Now, I will say that the free version of ProtonVPN is not going to be the fastest VPN in the entire world, particularly when the limited free servers are jam-packed with users. But I found the free version to work quite well when the servers weren't totally loaded. Speaking of server capacity, the free version gives you access to 3 server locations in the world, which covers Japan, the Netherlands, and the United States. You are, of course, limited to a small subset of those VPN servers in totality that they offer, but hey, it's free, so that's not a surprise. In addition to that, you are limited to using one device on the VPN service, which again is no surprise, it's free. But the fact that you get truly unlimited data capacity is truly the differentiator, and the 3 country options give you some flexibility to work with. You might also be wondering about the security and privacy part of this. That's important. From that perspective, ProtonVPN's locale for operations are a benefit here. ProtonVPN is operated from a very cybersecurity-focused and privacy-friendly jurisdiction, Switzerland, whose political stability and legal clarity help provide a platform for cybersecurity-focused companies to do what they do. Swiss privacy laws are your friend here. As a user of the free plan, your data is encrypted and your information is not being logged, mined, or sold for a profit, just like the paid version of ProtonVPN. Furthermore, since January 2020, all of their applications are open source, meaning the code can and has been audited for backdoors, malicious code, and more, so you can feel safe knowing that the application you're trusting with your data is not an opaque, sketchy affair. And finally, the free version of ProtonVPN was found not to be guilty of the cardinal sins of VPNs, which would be IP address, DNS, or WebRTC leaks during testing, which of course is critical for any VPN on the market. Naturally, this free VPN is not going to compare to paid VPNs in speed and server availability, etc., and it has limits in capacity and server locations for that reason. When there is heavy load, it might be less available than a paid VPN. And that being said, ProtonVPN does offer a paid version of the service, which expands your server locations available to 55 countries, lets you use 10 devices at once, or on the plan rather, and it will offer you much faster speeds. That is the precise reason that ProtonVPN offers the free service in the first place, so that users can try out the service without commitment, see if they want to upgrade to a paid plan. Oh, and before I forget, when you first sign up for the free version of ProtonVPN, you will download the software on your computer or on your phone or wherever you're doing it, and you will notice that you have access to way more than 3 servers. And people always ask me why that is. Because every single time you sign up for a free version with a new account, it now comes with a limited free trial of the paid version of ProtonVPN. So once that trial ends for the paid version, you're gonna go back to the free version automatically. Don't worry, that's just to give you a taste of what you could have with the paid version, but there's no commitment to buy. It's just automatically triggered. So people get confused there, but the VPN still is free. Again, you can sign up for the free version of ProtonVPN through the link down in the description and pinned comment of this video. And with that, let's go ahead and jump into the second option here for those of you who like to have options. I mean, who doesn't really like to have a second option to compare and choose from? The other free VPN that I've used that I felt was both adequately performant and free from malware and free from the normal issues with VPNs was the Ontario, Canada-based Windscribe. Windscribe is a free VPN that is available again across mobile and desktop platforms like ProtonVPN, but unlike ProtonVPN, it does have a limit on the data capacity that you can use for the service on a monthly basis. However, Windscribe offers more country server options for free users. So there's a balancing point there. You have a cap on your data, but you have more options in terms of servers. As of my last check, free servers are accessible in the US, Canada, UK, Hong Kong, France, Germany, Netherlands, Switzerland, Norway, and Romania for users of the free VPN service. And you have a total of 10 gigabytes of data allowance per month across multiple devices. So again, there is that limit. Those looking for Netflix support can use the UK and US servers to access those platforms, even on the free service as well. Windscribe overall offers a similar experience to ProtonVPN for the free service, but I did end up hitting that 10 gigabyte monthly limit on that data cap during testing, and I found myself often on Twitter or browsing media intensive pages like sports pages during the Olympics, and that ate up my data allowance super fast. However, again, this is a free VPN, so one should expect to run into limitations. Speed-wise, I felt that Windscribe was very similar to ProtonVPN overall, but it did have a slight edge because of the wider server options across more countries. There's just more room for free users at peak times with Windscribe, and I was able to routinely get around one-third, maybe optimistically one-half of my total network bandwidth at my house with the VPN enabled. My latency, of course, varied depending on how far away the server was that I was connecting to, but overall, one place that Windscribe was good, but not quite up to par with ProtonVPN, was in its approach to privacy. Not only because Windscribe is in a less privacy-friendly jurisdiction in Canada, it's also because they log a small subset of information related to the data usage of your session. I can't say that Windscribe is totally log-free like ProtonVPN because of this, even though it's not necessarily personal data that they're logging. That's not to say Windscribe is insecure or completely lacking privacy features or it's totally not private. It's just that I would prefer a privacy-friendly jurisdiction and absolutely no logging of my data usage for VPN, and that's just a personal thing. To some, this won't matter at all because one just wants to hop traffic through to another country or obfuscate their IP address, but to others, it could be a deal breaker, and so that's totally up to personal preference. And finally, in terms of the critical testing for a VPN that I alluded to before with ProtonVPN, Windscribe did pass testing related to common WebRTC, DNS, IP address leaks, which of course is a good box to check. Again, I've left a link to Windscribe down below for anyone who would like to try it out. Again, it is totally free. Now, free VPNs are great thing for people who are on a budget or that just want to get a little bit of security for their internet browsing, but maybe don't want to pay for a VPN. But there are a few really powerful paid VPNs that can cost as little as $2 per month to use, and they give you way better performance and features for streaming video and the like. I actually have a video dedicated to my absolute favorite paid VPNs that are budget friendly and full of features. So if you have time, please do check out that video linked below. I'll give you everything you need to know about it, as well as a discount code for the best possible price that I can get. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them here in the comments. And as always, thanks for watching. And until next time, cheers.